Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to start my talk with a simple survey that I want to conduct on you guys. The first question is, raise your hand if you complained about something, someone, or anything really in the past 24 hours. Great. Okay. Keep your hand up. Okay. If you thought of a solution for the issue or the person you complained about. Okay. And finally, have you taken the step to solve that issue that you complained about? Or did you talk to the person you complained about? Raise your hand if you did. Okay. I think you've noticed what's the message I want to tell you here today. We wake up first thing in the morning and all we can think about is complaining about work. You complain about college and we're dreading whatever it is we have to do for the day. And then we decide to open our social media accounts, which don't really help at all, because we hear other people complaining, and not just complaining about like politics and jobs, they complain about things that we take for granted. And don't get me wrong, I complain a lot. I just don't put it on social media, it's all in my head. An example of that is 2 weeks ago, I reached my limit, and I got really, 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 really frustrated because all of the attention that we give is to people who don't put much time and effort into their content. And there are so many content creators out there who deserve the attention for all their hard work, their efforts, and the time that they put in their social media content. However, people decide to go watch things that don't deserve the attention, and they share them on all social media, and then they complain that only stupid people get famous. And I have every right to complain about it, but what is the solution? Almost a year ago, YouTube contacted me and told me that I have been nominated to be a Creator for Change Fellow. And that was a huge deal, not only because it came from YouTube, but because a few months before that, YouTube announced the Creator for Change ambassadors. And I quoted them, and I told them that I wish and hope that one day I'll be alongside my two favorite creators, Ashwaq Al Maskery and John Green, and be a Creator for Change. It was crazy to be one of them. The thing is, I had a huge responsibility because I was powerful. I had that power to share a message, to share something with the world, and people will listen. But at the same time, it got a little bit overwhelming. I wasn't sure what was the topic I wanted to discuss the world with. And at the same time, how will I do it? How will I reach out to this audience? And what I decided to do was to discuss a topic that I was familiar with. I decided to write, direct, and produce a 4-episode series called Contagious. For every action, there is a reaction. And what we share is what will spread. I'm not going to tell you more about it because I want you to go to my YouTube channel, youtube.com/ashwaqalmaskery, and watch the series. And maybe, just maybe, if you like it, you can share it with your friends and your family. Once I was done with my videos, and they reached over 1 million views, I decided that I wanted to see what the other Creators for Change fellows did. Some of them made music videos that discussed different types of issues, but some of them actually took the step to create the change. We have Izzuddin Arif, a Yemeni YouTuber, who decided to go live a day with a German family. Then there was Nadir, who's a Yemeni, Pakistani, Kenyan, Malaysian, who is based in London, and decided to go with the Syrian refugees to help them, share their story, and do whatever he can in those few days to make them smile. Then there was Rosiana, a Mexican-British who decided to go to Colombia. And instead of just talking to them and trying to help them out, she taught them how to film, and she taught them how to edit their videos, so that they can share their stories to the world and we don't have to do it on their behalf. But one of the biggest stories that really impacted me, and it impacted the lives of many people, was a story that I heard and knew about actually before that, called the Love Army. I'm not sure if you guys heard about it or not, because it blew up on social media, because it started on social media. What happened was, a group of YouTuber, content creators, not all of them are YouTubers, they wanted to see what would happen if a group of creators came together and did something for a specific cause. What happened in that phase was Somalia was going through a really bad drought. People were hungry, there was not food, there was no water, there was nothing. And when they inquired about the issue and when help would go to Somalia, they were told it would take up to 4 months for help to reach Somalia. And that was not acceptable. Can you imagine how many kids would die out of hunger? How many families would starve during those 4 months? So instead of just complaining about it, they decided to take this step and be a role model to others. So they started the funding page and they made a video in 3 different languages to reach as much people as possible. And they raised over $2 million for Somalia. And that is a huge number. They were, the CEO of Turkish Airlines actually talked to them, he called them and he's like, what can I do to help? And they were provided with a 60-ton cargo airplane to take all what they need from Turkey to Somalia. And the thing is, they didn't just stop with Somalia. Once they felt that Somalia was doing good, they went to Mexico and helped people in Mexico. And right now they're in Rohingya, helping out the people. And the thing is, they don't just help out by giving water, giving food, and providing shelter. They actually teach them skills they need to survive on their own, so that they wouldn't have to depend on other people to do everything for them. They can do it themselves, and they can make money out of it. So what could I have done instead of complaining on social media about people not getting the attention they need? I could have went and talked to those people who created that content and give them the support they wanted. I could have went and shared their videos and their content all over social media and showed people that, you know what, we have people who do great content, and not all content on social media is just funny videos and people who maybe don't deserve the attention. But don't get me wrong. Everybody can watch whatever they want to do, and to each their own. If you want to make funny videos, if you want to make a fool out of yourself, that's your thing. You can do whatever you want. But it's our role to share the things we want to spread. Talking may or may not raise awareness. It may or may not lead to someone taking action. Talking is just talking. And right now, we don't need to talk. We need to be role models towards the change we want to see in this world. My name is Ashwaq Al Maskery. قيل ويقال بأنني غريبة الأطوار فوافقتهم الرأي. شكرا.